The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was once approached by a group of Sahaba. They said to him, Ya Rasulullah, najidu fi anfusina shay'an nu'azzamu an natakallama fih. They said, Ya Rasulullah, we find something in our hearts that is huge, big burden. Yani, we'd rather be charcoal than speak these words. Allahu Akbar. What are these words? Yani, words of kufr. Al-ulama rahimahumullah said, words of kufr, big words that a person is not supposed to say. They went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, we find this in our hearts. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, awaqad wajadtumuh? Really, you're finding something like this? They said, yes. He said to him, ذَاكَ صَرِيحُ الْإِيمَانِ. He said to him, that's a sign of iman. Allahu Akbar. Yani, what's a sign of iman? Not the evil thoughts are a sign of iman. The fact that they're inside of you and they keep circling inside of you and you keep remaining silent about them, that is a sign of iman. That is a sign of iman. Yani, this is a hadith, good news for people that have this kind of waswas. Relax. So long as you don't utter it and speak it out and preach it, then bi-idhnillah, you're upon goodness. And if anything, this is a sign of iman. How is it a sign of iman? Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he went past the Jews. Well, the Jews, they said to him, inna la nuwaswasu fi salatina. Yani, a Jew is trying to show Nabi sallallahu, he's trying to tell Ibn Mas'ud that we're better than you. How? He said, you people, you Muslims, you have waswas in your salat. وَنَحْنَا حَمْدُ لِلَّهُ, we have no waswas in our salat. Al-Yahud. He said to him, وَمَا يَفْعَلُ الشَّيْطَانُ بِقَلْبٍ خَرَابٍ. What's a shaitan going to do with a ruined, destroyed heart anyway? But أنت خلاص, you're going to Jahannam with him, he's finished. He's not going to waste time on you. نما, he's going to come to the believer, the one that's still firm and strong upon his iman. He'll come and try to bring him to become a Yahudi, وَالْعَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ, right? فَإِذَنْ, يعني, he said to him, وَمَا يَفْعَلُ الشَّيْطَانُ بِقَلْبٍ خَرَابٍ. This is how we deal with the internal waswas. يعني, we disregard it, we say Alhamdulillah. When Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam even said to those companions, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي رَدَّ كَيْدَهُ إِلَى الْوَسْوَسَةِ. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he gave them good news, he told them, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, that these matters, Allah Azza wa Jal categorized them as waswasa. He categorized them as waswasa. And so long as they're inside, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها, there is no issue at all. Reading, يعني, also what cures this issue is to read ayat that mention the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قل هو الله أحد وآية الكرسي. Allahu Akbar. If these ayat and these surah were read properly with a conscious heart, where you open up in the meanings of these surah, what kind of waswas would remain? It would shatter. It would shatter him. فإذا, these are solutions on how to combat al-waswas in matters of belief.